Hello, I'm George Kelesidis. I'm from the Particle Technology Laboratory of ETH Zurich, and here I'm going to talk to you about the oxidation dynamics of carbonaceous nanoparticles, such as soot that is produced by engines and flame reactors, such as this one over here. So soot nanoparticles are nucleated and grow by surface reactions, aggregation, and agglomeration before they react with oxygen at high temperatures above 1000 Kelvin at the exhaust of the flame. At these conditions, the effectiveness factor eta, which quantifies the relation between oxygen diffusion and reaction with soot, has a value close to zero. So surface oxidation is dominant and reduces the soot mobility diameter by removing mass from its surface. Diesel particulate filters have been designed to collect mature soot agglomerates that may have survived this surface oxidation process and further oxidize them at temperatures below 1000 Kelvin. At these conditions, the effectiveness factor has a value close to 1, so oxidation takes place within the pores of the soot primary particles that constitute the mature soot agglomerates that I showed you earlier. Now, the oxidation rate of mature soot is rather well known and similar to that of graphite, so it is of particular interest to derive the oxidation rate of small nascent soot nanoparticles that are present in the exhausts of gasoline engines. Of course, we can produce small nascent soot nanoparticles using laboratory flame reactors as well. For example, here you can see the normalized number concentration measured as a function of the mobility diameter of nascent soot nanoparticles produced by a premixed ethylene flame. The average mobility diameter of this size distribution is 12 nanometers, as these nascent soot nanoparticles make up these compact aggregated structures. So we'll use this measured size distribution as an input to our moving sectional model for internal and external surface oxidation of soot that accounts for the fractal-like morphology of these nanoparticles, as you can see over here. So for every section of this size distribution, we simulate the evolution of the soot mobility diameter and mass during oxidation of soot taking place at the surface of the soot nanoparticles, but also inside their pores. So we will compare our model to the size distribution obtained after oxidation for 200 milliseconds at these conditions. So you see, the average mobility size decreases from 12 down to 8 nanometers. So firstly, we used as an input to our moving sectional model the oxidation rate that has been derived for graphite by Nagle and Strickland constantly. This results in an overestimation of the average soot mobility size by 40%, as you can see over here. And this is due to the fact that nascent soot is more reactive compared to graphite and mature soot because it contains more hydrogen. In fact, we derived a nascent soot oxidation rate that is 5 times larger compared to that of graphite. So this new nascent soot oxidation rate can be used to design new after-treatment technologies to clean up these small soot nanoparticles from our atmosphere. Thank you so much for watching this video presentation, and I'm looking forward to meeting you at EAC 2020.